Welcome, everyone. My name's Jack Driscoll, and I have a show called Helping Hands. It's a new show I'm putting out to try to get the message out on so many different businesses and individuals in the local area here in Pittsburgh and Bethel Park that are doing good in the neighborhood, and I want to help them all share their message. So today, you'll see behind me, we have one of the family residences that's doing an event. It's actually for Halloween. It's Halloween time, and they're doing a haunted cemetery and collecting proceeds for the benefiting of children and St. Jude's. Before we come here, we have a spot up the street. This is on Greenwald Avenue in Bethel Park, and right next street over is Eastview, and they're carving pumpkins up there. There's a group, and it's again another family just doing good, and they're carving pumpkins and collecting for the MS as their cause. So you'll see they call themselves Carving for a Cause. And then there's so much going on in local areas with residences and businesses. So welcome to Helping Hands. It's Halloween time again. Halloween's next week, and we're out here with Amy, and Amy's crew actually is inside, part of Amy's crew's carving some pumpkins. So Amy, we just wanted to come out, have you introduce yourself, tell us a little bit about the background of how this all started, what you're all about.
Okay, I'm Amy Ruchling. I live over here on Eastview by Bethel High School. We started carving pumpkins years ago. My brother started with my three girls doing 10 pumpkins. We thought we were just all the rage doing 10 pumpkins. And every year we would do a couple more and a couple more and a couple more. We got up to about 70 or 80 pumpkins, and my two older girls went to college. And when you do that many pumpkins, you need people that really know what they're doing. So when they went off to college, we stopped, and the outcry in the neighborhood was awful. All the people were, where are the pumpkins? Where are the pumpkins? So a few years ago, probably about 4 or 5 years ago, we did it 1 year, and we did probably maybe about 90 or 100.
Wow.
And that was, again, upping our number. So we were always upping. We try never to go down. And they turned out great. And then about 4 years ago, we thought, why don't we try to add a little thing to this and collect money for the MS Society? I was diagnosed in 2000. So we always do the MS walk, which is great. And a lot of the people that are in my pumpkin posse, that's what we call ourselves, do the walk with us every year. And I was diagnosed in 2000, so we've been walking now for 18 years. And we thought, why don't we try to see if we can collect money for the society? So the first year, and I'm probably wrong, and my kids will tell me I'm wrong on these numbers, but the first year we collected, I think, like close to $2,000, which I thought was huge.
That is huge.
And then we were at about 2,400, which was great. Last year we collected about $3,800 or $3,900.
Really?
Yes, in two nights. And this year, I say this, but you know, you can never tell. Right. My goal this year is to collect $4,000, so we're getting close to the $10,000 goal for the society. And they'll be out on Tuesday, the 30th.
Okay.
And Wednesday, Halloween night, the 31st. Mm-hmm. We start lighting them right when it gets dark, because it takes about an hour to light them all. It takes a while.
Okay.
And then we are out late. So don't think 10 o'clock is too late to come see them. They will still be lit.
Okay.
We do leave them out overnight. Bethel Park Police last year were nice enough to send a couple extra patrols around to keep an eye on them.
Okay.
We didn't have any problem, which was nice. In fact, at 2 o'clock in the morning, we heard a car door out front of our house and then this light. And my husband got up and looked out the window, and I said, what are you looking at? And he goes, the policeman is outside of the car taking pictures. So he was taking some photos of it. So they did drive past about 3 or 4 times, which was great. I am going to call them on Monday to see if they can be a presence again.
Right.
They're out again on Wednesday. Mm-hmm. And again, they're out. We were outside Halloween last year till about 11 o'clock. So
Oh, really?
It's after trick or treat. If people do come, my concern this year is there's going to be a lot of people, so please try to park down the street and walk down to see us.
Okay.
I just want to make sure everybody's safe out front. You know, we have a lot of little kids that are here, so, you know, just to make sure everybody's, you know, kind of being safe, driving slowly and everything.
Is it okay to park up the side street also?
It's okay to park up the side street up Elgin. Yeah, I mean, Eastview is a very long road, so unfortunately, if you have to park down by the high school and walk down.
Yeah, you just want to not try to crowd the road on both sides.
Try not to be right in front of my house, yeah, because there's a lot of people out there. So maybe we'll get big enough that we'll get some type of busing from the high school.
You never know.
Who knows? But it's kind of neat. We've learned a lot of things over the years. When you have so many pumpkins, you can't carve them all or empty them all at once. You have to do them in stages. So we did 60. We cleaned out 61 the night before last. We did 60 yesterday. So every day we do another batch.
So it's the 25th today.
It is the 25th today.
So that was just yesterday you started?
Last night? No, the night before. Wait, what is today's Thursday? Tuesday night we started cleaning out.
Okay.
And then yesterday we started cleaning out another batch and we started carving.
So it's about a week in advance.
Right. Technically,
yeah.
Carving wasn't supposed to start till tonight. So we are about 47.
I see you already started.
We're about 47 in the good, which is good because if you tally it, it's about between 55 and 65 pumpkins a night that we have to have done.
How many total?
Our goal this year is 320. We did 304 last year, so our goal this year is 320. I have about 350, which I'm sure you're going to show here, all the beautiful big pumpkins.
Yeah.
That's a lot of pumpkins. I don't know that we'll get to 350. I think my pumpkin people would kill me. They might have something to say about that. Yeah. But we have, like I said, we have learned some things. I'm holding this special tool.
I noticed you holding
that.
Yeah,
my husband and our friend Pete, we've seen these on Facebook where people have sent me, oh, you put it on a drill and you just scoop it and it actually works. Mm-hmm. So last night they made this and it does work. So we're going to use it tonight.
So it cleans out the inside.
You just put it in like you're baking a cake.
Okay.
And it spins all the pumpkin
stuff.
Guts and then you throw it away. So that's the other thing. I you know, when people say, oh, this must be dirty. Just think of when you clean out one or two pumpkins at your house.
Right.
I'm cleaning out 320 at my house. So I find pumpkin seeds at Christmas, at Easter next year. I'll find pumpkin seeds. I found pumpkin seeds up in my light in my kitchen about 2 weeks after last year. So my house is a wreck for a week, but it's worth it. We have so much fun. We eat and you know, we sit in there and laugh and we're hopefully not going to have any injuries. We haven't had any injuries, so we're all real careful.
I was wondering about that. I see all this.
They're little.
Carving.
They're little teeny knives, so you don't have to worry too much. It's when we start getting into some bigger ones. I did use a bigger knife on Pinocchio's nose today, and I was really careful. So
this one.
Yeah, that one, because it was just kind of a long straight shot. So I figured I'd try that. But we do like the people will see them when they come. Like I always do Eaton Park cookie. We always do a BP. We always do a BP pumpkin. We do the Armed Forces. Harry Potter. We're huge Harry Potter fans. We're also huge Disney fans, so we have a lot of Disney. We do superheroes. We do ones for the adults, 007. I don't know.
Good Lord of the Rings and all that.
Yep. Lord of the Rings. I can't forget that. Lord of the Rings. My husband does a pig roast at the corner, which is always a fan favorite. There's just so many of them that we do. They're hard to remember them all.
It has to be fun, but it looks like such a job. Which wins out, the fun?
Probably the fun. I mean, the last few days leading up to this, every time I thought of the number, I'd get like a little sick to my stomach because, you know, we want to get them out there and then be beautiful because there's nothing like seeing them lit up.
Right.
You know, like there's Sully up there from Monsters, Inc. You really can't tell what he is now, but when you put a few candles in and it's dark, he's gorgeous. So so that's the big thing for us. It is fun. We sit in there and laugh and laugh and laugh. So it's, you know, it's a lot of work. It's a lot of work, but it ends up being just so, and people love it. They just love it. The kids love it. So
You're getting to be very well known. Every time is brought up, everyone knows exactly where the house is already, it seems.
I'm either,
what's your address so people know how to get here?
3051 Eastview. I'm on the corner of Eastview Road and Algene. So I'm on the end of Eastview that's closest to the high school, closer to Logan Road. So,
okay.
Yeah, so we're, believe me, if you come onto Eastview those two nights, you'll know where we're at, yeah. Because it'll be the one with a lot of people around it. But it is a lot of fun. We had a lot of donations. My pumpkins were all donated. I'm not allowed to tell you where I got them.
Okay.
I had 2,600 tea lights brought to my house about a week or so ago from a friend of mine, which is huge because it takes approximately 4,000 tea lights.
4,000 tea lights.
4,000, because it's between 3 to 6 per night per pumpkin. So they burn out through the night. So
you have to monitor them through the night and keep going.
And that's where the pumpkin posse comes in. That's where my three daughters, my husband, the Benos, their daughter, my daughter's boyfriends, our friends, the Serrells, they're all here. Yeah. We got sweatshirts this year that say the pumpkin posse on the back. So okay. If anybody has any questions, I can say, go see a person in an orange sweatshirt so they know. And we all carry tea lights with us because if we see one that's not lit, we go up and we light it. One of the things that I'd like to bring up, if I could, if people do bring their kids, keep them, you know, down, not to come up in the pumpkins.
Okay.
We might have a little bit of a, fence, if you will, with some, Christmas lights just to, that people don't come up in the pumpkins because it would be like a large game of Plinko. If one falls, then it's like dominoes down the hill. So we've had, you know, some little ones go up because they want to
not realize.
Yeah. So, because they are very delicate. Once they're carved, every pumpkin has a shelf life.
Okay.
And they go soft really quick. So by next Tuesday and Wednesday, not only am I the pumpkin queen, but I'm also the pumpkin doctor, and I sit in my side yard with toothpicks and any other means if any of them start to break. So they do get soft. But
now, do you have this on Facebook or anything that people could look at?
We do. We started a Facebook page, which right now has a lot of people attending. Like it's an event on Facebook.
Yeah,
we have a lot of people attending. My daughter's boyfriend also did a video a couple years ago of what we do. He has a stop action camera.
Oh, does he? Nice.
Yeah, so neat. So that was neat. We have been in the almanac. I didn't call the almanac this year, but Facebook is huge.
Okay.
That gets a lot of
people. How do they see that on Facebook?
I guess they can go to my Facebook, Amy Ruchling, I think, and see it. They can see it that way. We also have, unfortunately, he's not probably going to be able to make it, but he's going to send a camera crew, Ken Rice from KDKA, the spokesperson for the MS Society.
Okay.
He's going to send people out. So we do get different, you know, different ways of getting out there. I think word of mouth has been huge.
Probably.
You know, people know, people I work with, my family works with, you know, it's just the word gets around.
Now, how do people donate if they want to donate for the cause?
They donate here.
Okay.
We have my mother who does not touch a pumpkin, but she sits out there with the bag and she's the money lady. So if people try to hand me money, I say, don't give it to me. Give it to my mother. She's sitting there with the MS official bag in the driveway, and they donate there. If they want to donate directly to the society, they can send a check directly to the MS Society of Pittsburgh, and all they have to do in the memo line is put pumpkin posse, and then that will get to our total.
Okay.
Because they do count that for us, so that's nice.
That helps.
It does. Yeah. And I think when I talked to the society, when I talked to Susan Cook a couple months ago, we were like number 14 out of 20 or something, that the biggest raiser.
Wow.
So I was really proud of that. I was really proud of that with our little pumpkin thing. So that's what we do. It's fun. I love to have people come out and look at them. They're awesome.
Oh, absolutely.
Your cameraman said he'd been here, you know.
A lot of people have been here,
and I didn't even know it. You know, I walked into to Dunkin' Donuts today looking ridiculous. I had my Survivor buff on. I had these crazy pants on, and she laughed at me, and I said, I'm carving pumpkins today. And she said, oh, there's a house in Bethel. I'm like, what's my house in Bethel?
Yeah, good.
So, yeah, I guess we are getting a little bit of a reputation. But it's a
Can you show us around a little bit and show us how this process
starts?
And
I definitely can. Well, it's a lot of lifting, and this year has been
looks like it.
This year has been really something because of how heavy they are. I don't know that we have a pumpkin that's less than 10 pounds. They're all huge.
Wow.
So we brought them here, and we lifted them over our gate and then put them in piles. And then it was nice we had these big bins this year because that definitely helps kind of keep them contained.
Okay.
And like I said, we clean out so many at a time. Mm-hmm. And then we put those over here, the cleaned out ones.
Okay.
Like those are the ones we hope to finish in the next couple of hours. Mm-hmm. And then I have a crew of people coming tonight. I think I've got two ladies I work with and my cousin, I think, just showed up. And they'll be just cleaning out. They just will be cleaners.
Okay.
And then we'll put them in a different location. And then tonight, when it gets dark, because we can't be out here cleaning,
right,
then everybody will be inside carving. And
okay,
it will just be five people at my kitchen table, six people at my dining room table,
yeah,
people in my living room.
They're very good.
They are.
You call this event what? Carving?
Carving for a cure.
For a cure.
Carving for a cure.
Okay.
And I don't know that I can really even say I came up with that. I think Susan Cook from the society said it when she was here last
Is
year.
Is that right?
Like, carving for a cure. That's really good. So carving for a cure, and we're the pumpkin posse. We're the, you know, the crazies that do it. But
yeah,
yeah, they are great. They are good. There's a Sheetz pumpkin. My daughter loves Sheetz, so there's a Sheetz pumpkin. But yeah, there's all different kinds of there's a pumpkin for everybody. If you can't find a pumpkin here, you got a problem.
Yeah.
We got them all. We got them all. So, yeah, it's okay. Fun. And we have a lot. We still have a lot to do. I try not to look at what needs done yet because then I start to think, oh, yoy. But we're still one step.
Early.
Today's only Thursday, and I only have to have them done for Tuesday morning. So
yeah. That's good.
Yeah. So I think we'll do it.
Good.
I know we'll do it. It's just getting through this weekend.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
I appreciate your letting us come out, and I wanted to help share your
I appreciate you coming out, too, because I would love for Bethel to come see it. It's fun. It's a neighborhood thing. I would love for it. It's just it's a safe, fun thing for families, and there's no charge to come see it, you know?
Okay.
And what makes it special is it's just really 15 of us probably that do it.
Is that how many? 15?
About 15.
Well, you say just 15, but that's pretty good force.
Yeah, exactly. It totally is. And, you know, people send me pictures on Facebook of this house in West Virginia that has 5,000 pumpkins. Well, yeah, but everybody brought them those pumpkins already done.
Oh.
Ours are all done here, all by us, you know. So,
yeah.
And then what happens is the next day, we load them all back up in a trailer and take them all back up
to
where my... Yeah, you have to get rid of them. People don't think of that. Yeah,
I wouldn't have thought
what
of that.
What do you do with it? What do you do with them? So we take them back out to the gentleman that gave me the pumpkins.
Yeah.
He allows us just to... It's
put
kind of fun at that point because you're tired of pumpkins at that point, so you're just throwing them
right
up in the air and letting them break everywhere. And
right.
As long as I take the candles out, you know, he's good with that because he grinds them back up in their compost again, which
nice.
Is kind of neat.
That's nice.
Every year it's kind of sad to see them go.
Yeah.
And I'm already saying, well, next year, and then I think, oh, gosh. Think of what it's like to just do one pumpkin in your house, like I said before.
Over 300.
When you do over 300. Yeah, even 10 is a lot. But when you do as many as we're doing, it could be more than 5 days, but it can't be more than five days because, again, they have a shelf life. Once you cut into a pumpkin, it starts to decompose. Now, I will spray them with some bleach water. That helps a little bit.
Oh, okay.
I haven't done that yet, but I'm going to plan on doing that this evening with what we have done.
Okay.
And that does help keep them a little bit better. But by the time we're done, they'll be starting to get a little bit soft and some of them have a little bit of mold inside. That's normal.
Yeah. And how many – you said you have how many patterns?
I don't know. I have no idea. 1,000 at least.
Yeah.
At least 1,000.
Wow.
What is this one, Mary? It's two little kids, little boys?
They're sitting around a campfire.
Okay, so
there you go.
Now, you won't see that too well if she turns the pumpkin around. You won't be able to tell that too much, but if you end up putting a light in it, here, she'll put a light in it, and you'll be able to see it more. Then you can kind of see what it is. So, you know, when they're lit up, And wow. A lot of them, when we do them, after we do them, we put them on the kitchen counter, and I get a flashlight, and I'm like, look how good it looks.
Yeah, right. Wow, what a difference.
So, yeah, what a difference. You put a light behind it, and you can tell what it really is.
Yeah.
And then add to it being dark outside, and add to it being 300 pumpkins. Right. It's kind of cool.
Explain a little bit about this again. We're wrapping up all of what you showed us. Looks like an enormous amount of work.
It really is. We typically try to put some yard signs in just so the neighborhood knows, and people driving down, this is a very traveled street, so I like to let the neighbors know and everybody know that we're back again. So here we are back again, carving for a cure on the 30th and 31st for the MS Society. So come out and see us.
You're at it for another year at least. That's good news.
Another year. We're talking about next year already, which I don't want to think about that yet, but I want to get through this year, but we will probably be back next year too.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Right.
And your address again for everybody?
It's 3051 Eastview Road on the corner of Eastview and Elgin. Can't miss us. I'm the corner lot. Big tree with all the pumpkins in the front yard. That's us.
Very good. Perfect. And if they want any more information, go to your Facebook page.
Get my Facebook page, and we have stuff posted there. Pictures. There's pictures from last year and everything about this year, too. So hopefully you come out and see us.
Amy, thanks so much for letting us come out.
Thank you for coming over.
Good luck this year, and keep up the good hard work.
We will. Thank you very much.
Welcome, everyone. We're out here. It's Halloween time again, and I'm out here with Jason and Mandy. I'd like you to introduce yourself and tell us a little bit about what you're doing, what you're putting together here for Halloween for the kids, and where it all started, and just tell us a little bit about yourselves.
My wife, Mandy Zwolinski. I'm Jason Zwolinski. My son, Ethan Zwolinski. This started a long time ago, kind of on a whim. I just had a little small front yard, and I said, I bet you I could be a little festive while I hand out candy. And then next year, it just kind of grew and grew. And then we moved here to Bethel Park, and I had all this property. And I said, and now 10 years later, I've got this giant setup.
Yeah, setup.
Since this is my 10th year doing this, I've decided to make it a little bit special. I do this for the kids. I love kids.
Okay.
I started thinking about all the kids that, you know, really can't enjoy the festivities of the season.
Yeah.
Two things popped in my mind. Make-A-Wish, St. Jude's.
Okay.
So the first one I reached out to was St. Jude's. They were ecstatic.
Really?
Ecstatic.
And how did they get involved? How will this work this year with them involved?
What's going on is I'm going to be setting up a donation bin.
Okay.
This is all free, as usual. Okay. I hand out candy for all the kids.
Okay.
If you can make it through my gauntlet, I will shower you in candy. The problem is it's a little bit scary for the youngsters, so...
Beware.
Use your best judgment, parents.
Okay.
But I figured, you know, I draw a huge crowd.
Do you?
Huge crowd. Yeah. 300-400 kids now.
Really?
And my neighbor up the street on Eastview, she carves 300 pumpkins a year for MS.
Right.
I said, why can't I?
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, all it takes is a donation box and a sign.
Right. And a lot of effort.
And a lot of effort,
see.
Which I've already got. Yeah. And I have to point out, it's my beautiful wife here that she's really my backbone.
Yeah.
All of my neighbors at this point, they're involved.
Oh, that's nice. What's your address, first off, so anyone watching and listening to this knows where you are?
I am located at the corner of Logan and Greenwald, 3120 Greenwald.
In Bethel Park.
In Bethel Park. There is parking on the side of my property. I live in the corner.
Okay.
You can feel free to pull up. Be careful. Logan's a busy road.
The safe place, I would think, would be to come anywhere on Greenwald, because it's Greenwald goes a long, long way up there. They could park safely and stay off the road and let the cars come by at a slower pace.
My neighborhood is wonderful. It's nice and flat. Everyone is involved.
Mm-hmm.
You know, come on, bring your kids down. We'll have a great time.
Show us around a little bit, if you don't mind, on what you have set up so far. But again, there's still another week, and you said you're still setting some things up.
I start at the beginning of October, and I don't finish until about 5 minutes before those kids come. I've built As you can see, I have built my entire fence around my property.
Okay.
So just pallets and scrap wood, paint and nails.
Yeah.
I got tired of the cardboard and the foam tombstones. They blow away.
Okay.
So I've made wooden ones that are staked into the ground.
Okay.
I have about 1 million zombies. I only have, maybe 7 out right now.
Is that right?
Yeah, and I have to go. I actually have power circuits running through my yard to power everything. My son is very, very excited, and he'll most likely tell you that Daddy has 4 fog machines this year.
Fog machines.
4.
So he's excited, too. We're going to see him. We're going to meet him.
He was extremely excited this year. He helped out a bunch.
That's nice.
A bunch. It was really nice.
We're here with Ethan, and I understand Ethan was a big helper on setting some of this up. And what was your favorite part in setting it up? And also, say hi to everyone into the camera, Ethan.
Say hi.
Hi.
What did you like doing? You helped out on some of this set, on setting this up, didn't you?
Yeah.
And did you help with the fence?
Yeah.
And was that your favorite part?
Yeah.
What else did you help with? Were there other things?
Yeah. Actually, no.
What about the corn stalks?
I helped with the corn stalks, with ripping all of the corn off growing on it. You know why we ripped it off?
Why?
It's because a deer would destroy the corn stalk to get the corn off
the
of
deer.
It.
Yeah.
We
do have a lot of deer. Yes. That's right. You did a nice job on the fence. This
and we destroyed
really nice.
The corn onto the hill.
Did you?
What happens
That's
after that?
Good.
We put the corn up.
And the animals eat it?
The animals eat the corn that we whipped off.
Are you excited about Halloween this year?
Mm-hmm.
Is there any new thing that you've put down yet that wasn't here last year before we go that you can...
New things this year. I have more and more zombies this year.
Okay.
Everyone came out and they said, hey, you know what? You need more. And I said, yes.
Of course.
Of course I do. my wonderful sister, who totally gets my obsession, she has been traveling through antique road shows and everything.
Okay.
And a lot of this stuff isn't out yet. And it's really creepy just by itself. I haven't even dressed it or doctored it yet.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I want to thank you all for letting us come out and share your message with you. Thank you so much. Give everyone, if you don't mind, the details again, the address, how to, you know, come out here. It's from 6 to 8. And then a little bit about, more about how they can help your cause.
Okay. Again, we will have donation bins set up pretty soon. You can swing by anytime. Donate, cash, check, doesn't matter. I'm going to get it all together at the end and send one huge check for St. Jude's. It'll be here all week, hopefully.
Okay.
We'll be here until probably 11 o'clock at night on Halloween. We'll also be setting up online on Facebook, links to it in case you can't come down.
Okay.
You can still donate online in case you can't get out, if you're handing candy out. And you can't come down.
How do they do that?
It'll be online. We're going to put it on Citizens of Bethel Park.
Okay.
Maybe a few other Facebook. You'll
Perfect.
See it. It'll pop up.
Okay.
It'll be a link right to them. You just got to do the little internet magic.
That's very good.
Put your credit card number in, and there you go.
Okay. Thank you so much for doing this. I wish you luck next Halloween, and I'm sure we'll see a lot of people down. Come out and join them on Greenwald, and happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween.
Thank you all for tuning in and visiting what's going on for Halloween. Please feel free to come out, support these two, one on Greenwald and one up on Eastview. They're parallel roads. A lot of people come out. They'll come across Greenwald, go up and down that road, and then go right on the next road and support Eastview also. Please come out on Halloween. It's from 6 to 8 o'clock, trick-or-treating, and help support these two activities and families doing good in our neighborhood.